Here we go, it's last week of the auction, America's favorite top 10 list of auction results from around the globe, as hand-selected by me, Josh Levine, your host and a guide to the world of auctions. This is episode 1 of season 2. We are back, baby, the hottest YouTube series and social media sensation, and it's just like you took Brad Pitt, the Antique Roadshow, and the magic that is Santa Claus, bottled it, shook it, and now you get to look at it. Still with me? Of course you are. Yes, I've got a great show for you today, and welcome back, subscribers, and hello to my newbies. We got the goods, amazing auction results, fun facts, and so much more. I'm telling you, nothing is more interesting than the auction world, even during a pandemic. So, quick business. Before you leave, subscribe below, turn on notifications, please give this video a thumbs up, leave your precious comments below, and as always, share your ideas. I have the links in the drop-down section below the video to everything I discuss, all my social media channels, and where you can find out more about these great auctions. So are you ready? It's last week at the auction, season 2, Electric Boogaloo. Coming in at number 10 is a great piece. It's when art meets furniture. This crazy legs 27 inch table brought $3,250 at Claire's Auction Gallery in Oakland, California. Talk about provenance. This sale featured this and many other items from the estate of the late actor and comedian Robin Williams. All came from his home in Tiburon, California. And as always, remember, provenance can influence values. And should you ever buy a piece like this, keep any and all documentation to support the piece for later transfer. I cannot tell you how many times people tell me purported stories of their grandparents. But you know what? In today's world, documented chain of custody is necessary. Think blockchain, people. All right, coming in at number 9. Check out this lovely Chinese enamel vase that brought $4,000, also at Claire's in Oakland. It measured 20 inches tall and was decorated with peonies, bats, and a pair of mythical bees. And the reason I chose to feature this piece was to illustrate a point. See the drilled base and right through its mark? This was most likely a lamp at some point in its life. Once the kiss of death to Chinese antique vases, as these early pieces become more and more scarce or priced out of affordability, the collectors have been more and more forgiving or willing to spend good money on rare pieces with a few issues, like a hole in the bottom. There's a lot of lamps out there that are hiding Qing and Ming Dynasty vases, and I can already hear you taking them apart. Just thank me later. All right, coming in at number 8 comes from my buddy Matt from Matthew Bullock Auctions in Ottawa, Illinois. I know I've done videos before on Hot Wheels, but what's better to illustrate the madness than show you what he just sold this for? $6,500. Yes, a loose, ultra-rare 1976 Hot Wheels Hong Kong, white body, painted with Datsun decals, probably a prototype, but we're not sure. But I wanted to show you this because it doesn't need to be mint in the package to bring them in. Pretty cool. So here, number 7, I am Iron Man. I'm not Iron Man, but this is also pre-Black Sabbath. It's a 1963 Marvel Comics Tales of Suspense, issue number 39, which just sold at Bruneau and Co. in Cranston, Rhode Island for, are you in suspense, $7,750, and its value is, with most period comics, is that first appearance factor. These are what people are looking for, and condition was not a plus. At 4.5 out of 10, you see, collectors are willing to step up even when it's not the best of the best, because affording those these days is impossible. 9.6 just sold for $220,000 8 years ago. We head north for number 6, and it's a Canadian militia coat from the War of 1812. Quite rare and a wonderful scarlet red. I can just hear the Arizona battle cry, "The Canadians are coming! The Canadian." Okay, it's a snowbird joke and you have to live here to get it. Anyway, this coat just sold for $9,500 in Canadian dollars. For you history buffs, you have to remember during the War of 1812, which lasted until 1815, just to keep their country safe, Captain George Platt raised a cavalry of volunteers to defend Canada, just in case those crazy expansionists from America got any funny ideas. Here we are at number 5, and for those of you that watched my epic Pocket Change, The History of American Coins, you're gonna get this. An 1892S, meaning San Francisco Mint, as you learned, and graded AU58, as you also learned, sold for $11,000 at One Great Deal Auctions in Meridian, Idaho. Due to the low mintage, I think it was 1.2 million or less, that were made at the San Francisco Mint that year, they're quite collectible. Find one in almost uncirculated condition and you really have some money there. Being able to illustrate in real life during a pandemic the points I made last week in a video is quite satisfying. That's a lot of money. Coming in at number 4 and hoping my auction world friends that hate books are watching this. A 1953 first edition Casino Royale by Ian Fleming, you know, James Bond. This great estate find just sold for $19,000 and you would have donated it to Goodwill. I always call books the scratch-off lottery ticket of the estate and auction world. There's a lot of duds out there, but when you find a good one, yes, this is a good one. And the folks at Potter & Potter Auctions knew it. In Chicago, they had an amazing assortment. There were other Ian Fleming treasures in this one too. But this one is known to be one of 4,728 copies that were printed. Not a large run because he was not a well-known author at the time. And the fact is, the majority of these actually went to libraries back then. Pretty cool. So stop, I know what you're thinking. No stealing library books. Let's get to number three. Remember the auction at Claire's in Oakland that featured some of Robin Williams' goodies? It also featured items from the venture capitalist Frank James Caulfield's estate. And today, number three is an amazing 7th century BC Greek Corinthian bronze helmet. You know what it sold for? $30,000. An amazing example from the period. Truly a museum piece. I don't think provenance in this case trumped rarity or desirability, but now we're getting crazy and where only the auction world can take you. And again, these results are during a pandemic. Remember, online auctions only. Number two is out of this world, or supposed to be. It's a rare lunar module upper docking tunnel hatch manufactured by Grumman. And just what would one pay for something like this? $72,598. Yes, this late 1960s lunar docking hatch door developed and tested by Grumman for space usage that has no current purpose other than just being cool could have been yours for the low, low price of $72,598. You'll just have to wait for the next one. This sale at RR Auctions in Boston had some wicked NASA stuff. Space collectors have always looked for these really rare, early, one-of-a-kind prototypes. And you have to remember, most being developed for the government, many of these never see the light of day, let alone are available to the public. So when they are, it's an auction feast. That's why I want to do the auction at Area 51. Do you have any idea what the commission would be on selling alien body parts or implants or ET's speaking spell? I'm on it. All right, here we go. Number one, and with true auction power on display, it's a set of four chairs. What's going on here? I'll tell you what's going on here. I often speak about the current trends in the Chinese antique market and how hot it is, but most people, including me, always just think of bronze Buddhas or porcelain vases and not the furnishing. You know, and the furniture is where you really need to watch because there's a huge population in our global marketplace with a newfound disposable income and they want their antiques back because during the Cultural Revolution, they were scattered to the world. And now, thanks to modern technology and the online auction world, they're heading back and they're fetching a premium. Of course, it's for the best of the best, and these are rare examples. So, enough educational ramblings. How much do these four chairs sell for? $140,000. Yes, you heard me correct. This set of four Hung Huali Southern Chinese rose arm chairs brought $140,000. Hung Huali literally means yellow flowering pear wood, and it's a member of the rosewood family. Today, anything made from the real deal is highly sought after. Just like with Brazilian rosewood, this wood, the prices have increased largely due to the incredible scarce nature of the wood. I am sure that the folks at Roswell Auctions in Georgia were just as in shock when it happened as I was to read that it happened. So now, you know what happened last week at the auction. And for those of you with short attention spans, it's today's rapid recap. Let's do it monster truck style. Coming in at number 10 is Robin Williams' Modernist table for $3,250. Number 9 is the Chinese enamel vase at $4,000. And number 8 is the ultra rail 1976 Hot Wheels at $6,500. And number 7 is the first appearance of Iron Man, $7,750. Number 6 is the Canadian War of 1812 Captain's Coat, Captain, $9,500. Number 5 is the 1892 San Francisco Morgan Silver Dollar, $11,000. Number 4 is the first edition Casino Royale, $19,000. Number 3 is the 7th century BC Greek helmet, $30,000. Number 2 is the lunar space module space hatch, $72,598. And number 1, the Chinese chairs, $140,000. This week's question comes from Mark W. of Boston. Mark W. of Boston. Could that be Mr. Wahlberg? Cool. Okay, Marky Mark. All right, Marky Mark asks, are there any online instant appraisal tools that are any good? Hey, that's a great question, and my answer is some yes, some no. Just do a little homework. Recently, I broke down and used Just Answer, which is a great website. I'll have their link down there. And I was quite pleased. I was completely stumped, and they popped up in my window, you know, because how internet things work like that. They know what you're doing, and they know you're confused. So this thing popped up, and it looked like they had some freelancer online that was a Christie certified post-grad who would do research for you for a flat price. I don't even remember what it was, 35 bucks or something. And it was just what I needed. They actually found out what I couldn't figure out in hours. MortonAppraisals.com here in the Valley has an excellent online evaluation service as well. So yes, they are out there, but a lot of new ones are popping up with the COVID-19, and a few of the companies I've seen offering these services, unless they are outsourcing it, it would shock me if they knew Tupperware from a turkey baster. So watch out, because some of these auction companies are just using it as a bait and switch for consignments, unless that's what you're looking to do, is sell, 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 baby. Anyway, you can always email me photos too. I love a good mystery. Great question, Marky Mark. Thanks, and hey, all of you, email me at josh@joshlevinespeaks.com and feel free to send me all your questions and pictures or whatever. I try my best to get to all of them, and honestly, it's a lot of fun. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you enjoy the show, subscribe below, give me a thumbs up, leave your comments. You know, they are YouTube gold. That way I know what you like and want more of. So thank you, and I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Until next week, or last week at the auction.